In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, Most Merciful, today is Friday. Allah, you know, give me health. Because Friday, angels come. Allah send evil and angels lot. Friday, especially. So, if I pray, oh Allah, give to me health. Suppose, angel says, Ameen. Allah accept that dua. Otherwise, you know, you have to be suffer. Okay, now. My points, always I give to video, new point. That's why I make video, otherwise I don't want to be. This is my videos, if I am not in this earth, inshallah, whoever they really wants here after life, they can consider, they can think what I give to points in my videos. No one give to you. This is my challenge for today's scholars also. This is honestly I'm giving challenge because I am the Muslim. I don't want to be proud for myself, but my Allah give to me, you know, the what sign show us Allah, thus I give to that in my videos. I convey the message like God give to me sign and then I convey the message for my viewers. If you are really here after life once, be serious. Otherwise, in this, you know, evil smash your life. Okay, now the point. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam only went seven heavens he saw and went top of the world, top of the heavens. Allah throne very high and he made over there only Allah. Allah listening. And other religion gods listening to. When he went Allah place, he didn't see any Hindu gods. First point for Hindus, he didn't see any Hanuman or Ram or Shiva or Brahma, even you know Shankar, even Venkateshwar, he didn't see over there. What is this point? Okay, Hindu says, you know, we have God. So why God not show you heaven and hell and what? God not show you seven heavens, what is over there, aliens and what is the creature over there, what is the, you know, heaven means, what is the hell means. He didn't give to you details because he didn't went over there. When, suppose if you say your God came in this earth and he didn't went again, in the heaven and he not came back. This is the point for Hindus. Christians, think about it. When Allah called him, that time there is no Jewish God, there is no Christian God. Christianity you make and you say you have one God. Jewish make own religion, they says we have our universal God. But commandments, if you not follow Allah, that's why Allah take out Jewishism and Christianity in the Islam. He kept only Islam for prophets and books. So when Muhammad went over there in the Miraj, call that Miraj, the time, you know, he met with Allah, via Gabriel and Burak, he have traveled, you know, like plane you can say. So Burak, so he went over there and he saw only one God, Allah. He didn't saw any. Suppose if you say, no, your story. Okay, so where is Gabriel? Why he not came and why not he explained? Okay, why Jesus came 2000 before? Why not he came before also? Why he not told this story? One prophet is coming. Because if you know his forecast, if he can predict, someone coming in heaven and he wants to be lie like he's a liar. Like. He didn't say that. When the Jerusalem, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam pray, all prophets behind Adam to Isa, son of Mary. All prophets, you can mention names only 25, but if you go 124,000 prophets pray with him. He's a imam, he's a leader, he's a pastor, he's a, you know, father like. He prays Allah. So what is the dignity? Why he pray and why Almighty not give to Jesus to Imam like leader like and he can pray for, he can lead everybody? No. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay. This is a story is not true. That time, whoever they, Jew or Christians and pagans, non-believers, they know that. He's lying like, okay. So they ask, "Oh Muhammad, you are in Makkah. And this is a story you're telling at Masjid-e-Aqsa in Jerusalem. David time, that mosque. And you went over there and you put together every prophet over there. You call the azan and you pray Salah. You bow down in front of Almighty God Allah. So tell that story." So he told every story. What happened? How they look like Masjid-e-Aqsa? What is the Jerusalem? What is his travel journey on the sky? What is the Gabriel? He told everything. Burak story. How come? They believe later on, they become Muslim. Many Jew and many Christians become Muslim. Suppose if Jewishism true, so why Almighty God give to permission to change the religion? Christianity is true, why he give to the change the religion Muslim like? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam time, Jew and Christian become Muslim. Okay, now the point. Allah says if you are become Muslim, and then you change. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam time also, the guy non-believers, you know, they whisper the minds, Muslims, they weak faith, they become again non-believer like. So Allah says, kill these guys, because when you die, you can see Allah only. Okay, now the point. Hindu religion. Hindu says, you know, Sita kidnapped Raman 14 years, and she become old, and he threw. He sent it back Ram place. She become old, 14 years. He use her. What is this? My evil mind. I'm asking Christian, Hindu. Why not purity over there in the story? 14 years maybe he go with her, Ravan. She not pure. Okay, if you say she is a pure, 14 years after he checked that, so what he checked? 14 years where is she? He don't know. When he check after, you know, punishment like 14 years you pure or not. She was front of Ram that time he check, and he don't know 14 years where she was and what's going on over there. Okay, now one more point. He have Hanuman. Oh, he's a Spider-Man, he's a Batman, he's a Superman. Like he travel everywhere in you, he help everybody. He carry, you know, mountains. What is this story? When she was in Ravan place, Sita, he can't find 14 years. Today is satellites, Iraq or, you know, Iran. What's going on, you can see. Satellites, man create these and you can see wherever you want. This is the new technology. So he's a powerful God. He don't know where is she. What kind of this story is, my brother? Wake up. I'm well-wisher. Oh Hindu, wake up. I'm well-wisher. Oh Christian, try to understand. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam powerful. That's why Allah says, "Inna Allah wa malaikatu yasalluna ala nabi ya ayyuhallazina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslim." Myself and my angels, every single says, "Peace be upon Muhammad." Allah says this, Almighty God, God listening, your God listening, your angels listening. So how come every single second in this earth, two surahs reciting too much like in this earth? One is Surah Fatiha, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Every day Muslim reciting. What is this? Christians going wrong. Jewish got the punishment in the Surah Fatiha. This is a challenge for Jew and Christian. And God is the only one, alone and eternal, unseen, in the Surah Ikhlas, Qul Huwallahu Ahad. So Jew and Christian understand Surah Fatiha, they warning Almighty God Allah. And Hindu can understand God only one, they show, you know, millions. Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar.